Because a lot of
I
the
think
brands
are
thinking, what do I do?
Yeah. And information is out there, right?
Yeah.
Brands are more resistant to participate in fiscal models.
Yeah. Today we are once again with Jorge Villalaide, who is the general manager for Yellow Motors. Nice to see you again, Jorge.
Same here, Alan. Thank you.
Good. Now, a while back, jointly, there was a car buyer's behavior report that was happening with the GCC. Yellow Motors led it, I mean, supported it. Tell us about some of the findings. What was the finding? What was startling about it?
So I believe one of the major findings out of the report was the importance of the online throughout the research phase,
okay.
Right? Then under the online umbrella, which there is a lot of different informations or various mediums at the end of the day,
okay.
The report revealed that third-party and unbiased websites are the most trusted source of information while people buying a vehicle. We saw this as an opportunity. Mm-hmm. Right, and we thought with the team to launch a new product, right?
Okay.
Which is now what we are launching in the next couple of days, which is going to be by end of October this year, 2019. It's the first ever virtual motor show. So mm-hmm. eventually we understood, right? I mean, there is a massive potential in the digital arena, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah.
People trust our brand enough, right? Which I believe that's wonderful, especially for us. It's a huge responsibility.
Of course.
As well. And we decided, listen, I mean, we do have the technology. Yellow Motor is part of Bay.com. Bay.com works for us as a group. We have other companies that we collaborate with, and actually that Bay.com owns. One of those is VFairs, which is a platform that is specializes in building virtual events. Okay. So we are collaborating with the VFair teams in order to launch this virtual motor show.
Sort of virtual motor show.
So we are trying to replicate the physical experience, mm-hmm. but in as in an online application. So and actually we're seeing it over there. This is the first demo we released.
Okay.
But without the pain points that eventually, or the frictions that a physical motor show has.
Okay.
Right? We need to leverage from the all these online experiences that are happening. We need to leverage as well from the technology that it's moving forward very quickly, and how we can actually reduce that gap from the online experience to an offline experience. So that's why we came up with this very interesting concept and tried to create that online experience out of an offline experience. So in the virtual motor show, you will have an entrance. From the entrance, you go to a hall. From a hall, you go to the particular pavilion, booth, stand, you name it. And that particular stand will have different functionalities when it comes to lead generation, branding, watching videos, 360 images, and a lot more that actually I don't want to say right now, because I would love people to browse it and give us our feedback. But that's mainly the idea. And it's something that at the end of the day, people can browse 24/7. They can use any device. It's a lot more cost effective for a manufacturer than a physical motor show. Mm-hmm. We are not only, let's say, limiting this for the UAE, but it's something that goes across the GCC, so you get a greater audience, and the amount of information manufacturers will be able to gather and collect is a lot greater as well.
Okay, great. So how are you going to market this? Great idea, great concept, and we're going to talk about this shortly, but how are you going to market this?
So the way we're going to market the virtual motor show is we're going to use our massive audience we have on a monthly basis.
Okay.
If I'm not wrong, at least this month, we are closing 2.5 million sessions. I mean, there's nowadays no automotive website that can gather the audience. We gather.
Okay.
So we're going to use that. We're going to use bait.com as well, whereby we can access to a database which is greater than 38 million people, and we can target them accordingly, nationalities, where do they live, cities, incomes, etc., etc., etc. We're going to use all our digital channels, YouTube, social media as well, just to drive more traffic, but very targeted. I mean, we really want the car buyers.
So as much as you can tell me, obviously there's the convenience, there is the cost benefit, and there is the fact that you're going to capture people at an early stage of the consideration, let's say. If I was an OEM, what would be the benefits of getting into this motor show? And if I was a dealer importer, what would be, it's mainly the OEMs, but what would the benefits they would get, as much as you can tell us? I know it's an early stage. And also, what are the benefits for the dealer importers?
Both of them, they definitely need to work together.
Of course.
Right? Yes. So, for example, we are now closing deals with manufacturers that eventually they're pushing these to the dealers, right? So I would say one of the main benefits is, to begin with, is cost effective. It's something which is open 24/7. People can access at any time from any place.
Okay.
And it's a great source of branding and lead generation.
How are the brands perceiving it? Are they supporting you?
They are. I mean, honestly, I was the other day presenting this product to the entire group, and one of the things I actually mentioned is, like, I launched various products, not only here in Yamamoto, but from before. And this is the first time they're actually calling us instead of us calling them, right? Wow. There is a massive excitement. Most of them, they're really interested in participating, all right? So we're working with them, with all together, right? Because definitely we want to make it a success. And eventually we want to take this product, let's say, global.
And interestingly, and sadly, if you read the news, Detroit, London, Frankfurt, certainly, they are shrinking, and all the news that you read about, Frankfurt is not Frankfurt, and so many names, you got all these big names that were absent, and etc. Do you see that in reality? It's eventually gonna replace the motor shows as we know it.
I believe the motor show will remain important, but what I really believe is that there's so many motor shows out there.
Yes.
So moving forward, let's say, if 5 years or 10 years, we will have worldwide 3 or maximum 4 motor shows, one in America, maybe another one in Europe, in Asia, and the other one could be, in this area.
The rest of the world.
The rest of the world or something like that.
Okay.
Right? But nowadays, I mean, you have so many motor shows, that I think it's clutter at the end of the day. And for the brands, it's a massive investment.
Yes, absolutely.
It's a massive investment. It's coordination. I was discussing this with, for example, with VW Group, right? And they have a dedicated team, and it's like all year long working for motor shows, So I asked them, listen, when did you start working on the Frankfurt Motor Show? And they told me from the previous Frankfurt Motor Show.
Wow.
Right? Yeah. Whereas on this one, it's like in and out, boom.
I also heard through the grapevine that a particular brand, they plan to launch a vehicle.
Your sources.
In the motor
it's like your sources are good.
Thanks.
We are currently working on that.
Okay.
We are part of the. Of course, we do have an embargo, so I cannot go out there and say X brand will eventually launch a vehicle and things like that. But yes, we are negotiating the terms. We are very excited.
So I wish you all the best. Please do keep us updated. Really, really interesting to see how that goes. But yeah, great idea.
We'll do, absolutely. And thank you, Alan, and the entire Amina team, always supporting us
With pleasure.
With these new executions and our reporting, you know, and getting in touch with the right people. So thank you very much. And yes, we'll definitely let you know.
Brilliant. Thank you, Jorge. Good to see you. Thank you.